This is not the time to sing only you, but rather we have to sing only I. Ladies and gentlemen, have a look right here. Starting with I, and let's look at this as I to the first power. And everybody knows 4 over 4 is equal to 1. But I know 1 is the same as 4 over 4. So I'm going to put this down as I raised to the 4 over 4 power. Well, let's continue by looking at this as I to the 4th power and then raised to the 1 over 4 power. Well, I to the 4th power is just equal to 1. And then this right here, let's just put down the 4th root. And finally, we can see that the 4th root of 1 is of course just equal to 1, right? Well, from here to here, I have no problem with it. But if you look back, what we are trying to say is that I is equal to 1. Oh my god, what kind of new discovery is this? I have never knew about this. Seriously, I is equal to 1? No, of course not. And you guys told me this already, the mistake is at step number 3 right here, right? Well, in this video, let me explain all the things that I think you should know. First, from here to here, again, we have no problem with the fourth rule of 1 is equal to 1. But we just cannot say 1 is equal to I. So let me cross this out first. And now let's just look back. Is it okay for us to say I is equal to the 4th root of 1? Or maybe look at this backwards. The 4th root of 1 is equal to I. What do you guys think? Well, the truth is, I will tell you, this right here is somewhat okay. So let me just put down okay, but in a quotation mark. And in fact, this is what I learned after I came to the United States. It seems that you can say whatever you want to say as long as you put a quotation mark around it. That way people seems to be, you know, they can understand you automatically. But anyway, this is somewhat okay. And the reason is because there are, in fact, 4 fourth roots. So let me just write this down in words of 1. And especially when we're dealing with complex numbers, when we're talking about the fourth root, usually we shall find out all the possibilities. And the secret is that, in fact, I is one of them. And here, let me just tell you guys what are the 4 fourth roots. Well, we will have 1, negative 1, I, and also negative I. And of course, I is one of them. So now, you see, if you put this down, what are you trying to say? 4th root of 1 is equal to I. You only put down one possibility. How about the other 4, right? How about the other 3, I mean? This is like what, you know? Yes, I'm telling you, hey, I'm going to treat you a 4-course meal tonight. But in the end, I'm just buying you the soup. And you have to pay for the entree, dessert, the drink, the second course, things like that. How would you feel? So I'm going to leave that to you guys. Right, for that. Alright, so now, let's really talk about this right here. Why are we doing this way? Could we have done it as I to the 1 over 4th power first, and then raised to the 4th power? That's the main issue that we would like to talk about right here. So, let's go ahead and put that down. If we only put down I to the 4th power, and then raised to the 1 over 4th power, versus I to the 1 over 4 first, and then raised to the 4th power. Well, which one is correct? Or are they actually the same? Here, let me tell you. In fact, this right here will actually give you 4 answers, just like what we have been talking about right here. And here, you actually will just get 1 answer. The truth is, whenever we are working with a fractional exponent, with the complex numbers, we have to be super, super careful. And now let me just explain to you guys why these are how they are right here. Now let's take a look at what do we do when we have I to the 4th power and then raised to the 1 over 4th power. Well, we are going to do this inside out and we will find out all the possibility. Check this out. When we have this, of course, I to the 4th power is just equal to 1. And then we are going to raise this to the 1 over 4th power. We are going to do everything in the polar form. And then let's see. To do so, I'm going to take 1, right? Put on the complex plane, which is right here. This is the real axis, and this is the imaginary axis. R is equal to 1, and then the theta is just 2 pi. So far, so good. So we are going to write the one in terms of the polar form, right? So this right here will be 1 times e to the I theta, which is 2m pi, like so. And then after that, we will, you know, raise this to the 1 over 4th power. And now you see, we have this raised to the 1 over 4th power. We will actually get 4 answers. To do so, what we can do is multiply the powers, and we get e to the I, and then we just have n over 2 pi. And to get all the answers, all we have to do is plug in 0, 1, 2, and 3 into the n. And the truth is, this right here is equal to 1, and this right here is just equal to I, and this right here is equal to negative 1, and this right here is equal to negative I. As we can see, we do have 4 different answers. Okay, so that was good. Now, let's check this out. What if we start off by looking at I to the 1 over 4th first, and then raised to the 4th power, like that. Well, this time though, because we have the 1 over 4 right here for the I, we are going to take I and put that into the polar form first, and then there will be 4 answers. Here, this is I, and the polar form is going to be the following. I is right here, and again, let's just make it prettier, RE, and then IM. Anyway, R is equal to 1, and then the angle theta is equal to, that's pi over 2, and don't forget, just add the 2 pi. So for I, this is what we are going to get. R is 1, so we just have E, and then I, and let's get the common denominator, so we'll just get 4n plus 1 over 2, right? And then we also have the pi right here. So this is what the I is. Then we are going to raise this to the 1 over 4th power, and then we are going to raise this to the 4th power. Alright, so that's what we have. Now check this out. What we are going to do is, we can do this times that, and then remember we have 4 answers, so just make sure you plug in n is equal to 0, 1, 2, and 3. And let's just go ahead and do that right here. I will just do 2 things at one time. N is equal to 0, 1, 2, and 3. So what exactly are we going to get? For this part, when n is equal to 0, this is just 1 half pi times 1 over 4 is just the 1 over 8 and then pi, also the I. So the first answer here is e to the I pi over 8. Next, we will have e, and then when you plug in 1, you get 5, and then you still have the 8 on the bottom. So I 5 pi over 8. And then e to the next one, you get 9. So I 9 pi over 8. And lastly, e to the 13, right? So that's I and then 13 pi over 8. Pretty good. So this part, the inside, we do have 4 answers. However, we are going to take each one and then raise to the power of 4. And now, here's the deal. We're going to just multiply the exponents. It still looks like we have 4 different answers, right? But you know what? Let me tell you guys that. The truth is, this right here is equal to I. This right here, 5 pi over 2, which is also that angle, it's also I. Likewise, 9 pi over 2, it's also right there, it's I. And lastly, is 3i. No, just kidding. I don't know why I wanted to do that, but anyway, I'm sorry. I. So, this is not the time to sing only you, but rather we have to sing only I. I know it sounds so conceited, but no. In math, it's okay. The answer is just only I. We don't have one answer. So you see, this is actually a legitimate way to take care of that fractional situation. And you might be wondering, seriously, why is that? When we do the exponents in a different order, how can we end up with different results? Well, you can blame on the complex numbers. And let me tell you though, in fact, the real problem with this is that we didn't reduce the fraction. So instead of looking at I to the 4 over 4, like this or that, we get 2 different answers. But if you look at, let's say I to the 3 over 4, which the fractions in the reduced form already? Well, you end up with the same answer regardless which way you do it. So now let me show you guys that real quick. What if we do I and then do the third power first and then raise to the 1 over 4th power? In this case, you see 3 over 4, you cannot reduce the fraction for that. Well, anyway, inside wise, this is going to be negative I, and then we are going to look at this raised to the 1 over 4th power. And you know the usual business, let's take the I to the, let's take the negative I now to the complex plane, which is right here. This time though, the angle is 3 pi over 2, and then you just add a 2 pi, right? Okay. And then again, let's put on RE and also the IM, because I made a horrible mistake before, so I really feel like I should put on RE and also the IM. If you guys know what I'm talking about, thank you. Anyway, so negative I, it's going to be, well, RE I theta, so R is equal to 1, and then we have E, and then I, and let's just get the common denominator, so we have 4n, and then plus 3 over 2, and then the pi. So this is what we have for negative I. And we are going to raise this to the 1 over 4th power. Well, again, we can just plug in 0, 1, 2, and 3, and also multiply the exponents. So let's go ahead and do that real quick. And perhaps I will multiply the exponent first. It's slightly easier, I think. Anyway, this time we get 4n plus 3 over 8, and then pi, and then n is equal to 0, 1, 2, or 3. Plug in. So we do have these four answers. That's it. Now, have a look right here. Suppose today we did that by looking at I to the 1 over 4 first and then raised to the third power. Well, I to the 1 over 4 is equal to what? We talked about it earlier, so I'm just going to put down the result. Now, we are going to raise everybody, right, individually to the third power. Are they the same? Yes, they are. This checks with that, right? So check. And then we have the 15, so this right here, so checks. So two checks. Now, here's the deal. 27 pi over 8, it's over 2 pi already. So what you have to do is just subtract 2 pi, and then give you a common denominator. So this is actually the same as 11 pi over 8. That's pretty much the period of sine cosine. So this right here, three checks, 1, 2, 3. This is actually the same as that. 1, 2, 3. Right? So again, this is the same as e to the I 11 pi over 8. And lastly, if you look at 39 pi over 8, you have to subtract multiple of 2 pi and just make sure that the angle is within 0 to 2 pi. Well, in that case, you are going to subtract 4 pi, and that will give you 7 pi over 8. So this guy, 1, 2, 3, 4, it's actually the same as 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the same as e to the I 7 pi over 8. So, ladies and gentlemen, as you can see, when you have this right here, in fact, it doesn't matter how you do it. So, when exactly can we do that? Well, let me summarize all this for you guys. Well, let's say z is a complex number, and then we have m over n. So this right here, okay, is equal to either z to the 1 over n, and then to the m's power, and you can also define this to be z to the m's power, and then to the 1 over n's power. So they are all okay, under the assumption that if the greatest common divisor of m and n is equal to 1. If the m and n, they don't have any common factors other than 1, then you can do it either way, just like what we are doing right here. But suppose this is reducible. Come on. Just go ahead and reduce the fraction. If you ever have to do that I to the 6 over 8, well, in this case, seriously, just go ahead and do I to the 3 over 4 and then be happy. Come on, all right? if GCT of MN is not equal to 1, then just reduce the fraction and L over N, all right? Or you do it this way. The right way to deal with a fractional exponent is that you do Z to the 1 over N first and then raise to the M's power. So this shows you why earlier we should do I to the 1 over 4th first and then to the 4th power, right? So hopefully this helps. If you find this video interesting, then you can continue the learning at Brilliant. It is a math and science website app with a focus on problem solving, and they have over 60 interactive courses in math, science, and computer science, and they are always adding new ones. I like their courses because they are interactive and have storytelling, which make the learning process a lot more fun. They always challenge me to pay attention to technical details, just like what we did today, and they teach us how to think outside the box. It doesn't matter what your level is, because they have something for everyone. Go ahead and get started with their basic courses such as algebra or geometry, or go ahead and get to the advanced topic like calculus or quantum computing. Better yet, use the link in the description, brilliant.org/blackandredpen, to get 20% off discount for the annual premium subscription. Thank you for checking them out, and thanks to Brilliant for sponsoring this video. So I think that was the reason why that you guys told me this right here is the mistake, right? But you know what? In my opinion, this right here, I think it actually has a bigger issue. And of course, I'm putting this in a quotation mark. Because why? Seriously, why? Why in the world would you like to write I to the first power as I to the 4 over 4? It doesn't do us any good. And then it becomes so complicated after that. Oh my God. Seriously? Yeah. So in my opinion, that's where the bigger issue is. But let me tell you though, if you really want to deal with I to the 4 over 4, just like what we talked about earlier, be sure you do the 1 over 4 power first and then do the 4th power on the outside. Or better yet, just write it as I to the 1st power. Man, who did that? Yes, it was me.